Hi friends, welcome to Amazon World. So with this video, I'll be starting to upload videos of Financial Accounting 2022 syllabus. And this video will be in English, and I'm not sure to how extent I'm going to upload English videos. So I'm going to begin. There's four frameworks of accounting, and this belongs to the chapter Accounting Fundamentals. Okay, and the very first study note in it is four frameworks of accounting. So there are four frameworks of accounting: conceptual framework, legal framework, institutional framework, and regulatory framework. So to explain this conceptual framework, I'll be using a recipe book. Okay, so I'll be explaining everything in regard of this recipe book only about conceptual framework. Okay, so as I said, let's think of the conceptual framework as a recipe book for financial reporting. Just like a recipe book guides you on how to cook a dish, the conceptual framework guides businesses on how to prepare their financial reports. Okay, so if you ask me what it is, it's like a map that shows you where you want to go and the paths you can take, right? Each and every one of us has goals, and in order to reach that goals, there is a certain process, and that process is the basic ideas. Okay, it helps us make sure that financial reports do what they are supposed to do. Like, why are we using a recipe book? We are using a recipe book because we don't want to end up whatever we are making very worse way, right? We want to make whatever we are going to make in a very beautiful way, right? So it should be tasty. At least it should be tasty. And we want to make everything perfect. So that's why we're using a recipe book, of course. So this helps, this conceptual framework helps make sure that financial reports do what they are supposed to do, right? Like a recipe ensures your dish turns out right. Now, it points out the destination of financial reporting to provide useful information of decision making. And also, this conceptual framework, it's like a cooking guide, as I mentioned, telling you what ingredients we have to use. So ingredients here refers to the transactions. And it also teaches you how to measure the ingredients, mix them together. That means what I'm referring here is summarizing it. The transactions what we are using, and we have to summarize it. And finally, what do we do after making a dish? We have to present them in a very beautiful way, right? So, presenting the dish is referred to as a reporting. Okay. Now, it states why we are cooking in the very first place. That means a purpose, why we are doing it, right? To give people the information they need. Of course, like nutritional facts and all. And it ensures that everyone gets the right information to make good decisions, like choosing a healthy meal. So this entire conceptual framework, as I said before, I'm just explaining it with the help of a recipe book, right? So this also helps ensures everyone gets the right information about to make good decisions. So in order to make good decisions, we require information, and this provides that. Now it describes what makes a good dish. What makes a good dish means I'm referring here is a financial statement, such as being clear, accurate, right? It should be understandable. A financial statement should be clear, accurate, understandable. So that is a guidance on quality. Now importance. It helps build a strong kitchen. Strong kitchen here, I meant, is institutional framework. This conceptual framework will help us to build an institutional framework, which is the upcoming framework, where everyone knows what they are doing. It's there to help chefs. Here, in our case, chefs are accountants. They create new recipes. So accountants create new accounting policies. When there is no existing recipe, that means when there is no accounting standard for a particular transaction or event, what happens? We require something to guide us, right? So this conceptual framework acts as such. It is like something that guides us. It's like a blueprint. Okay, so that's why I've added that Kathi film scene of this blueprint. I'm not sure how many of you can relate. South Indians can relate to it. So this is a scene of the film Kathi, where superstar Vijay sir just look into a blueprint of a building or something, right? And planning it out. So it is a very beautiful scene. So whenever I talk about blueprint, this scene comes to my mind. So that's why it will help you, all of you, to relate to it. That's why I added this picture. So this conceptual framework, simply you can say, just like it acts like a blueprint. Okay, so whenever there is no accounting policies to guide us, this can guide us. Fine. Now, in short, the conceptual framework is there to make sure that financial reporting is done consistently and provides high quality information that is useful for everyone who reads it. Just like a good recipe book helps you make delicious and satisfying meals every time. So I hope conceptual framework is clear. There is nothing to fret over it, because it's just that I've given you the very short notes. Just by reading it, you will get to understand. I've made it much more easier than our study mat. Okay. You can use these notes to link into big sentences. And you can also use this understanding as well. Don't write about recipe books and all in your exam paper. It's just that I want to explain it with something that can, that makes you relate. Next, I'm going to explain is about legal framework. So imagine you are playing a board game like Monopoly. Imagine you are playing a board game like Monopoly. Each type of game has its own set of rules that tell you how to play, what you can and cannot do, and how to win or lose. In the same way, businesses are like different types of games, and they have each have their own rule book and tells them how to operate, right? In India, these rule books are called statutes, and they are specific to the type of business. For example, partnership firms. Partnership firms follow the Indian Partnership Act 1932, or you can say for LLPs, Limited Liability Partnership Act 2008. These acts are like a guide on how partners should work together, share profits or losses, and what happens if a partner wants to leave or if a new one wants to join. They have to follow this, right? They have to follow these rules under this act. Now, when we talk about cooperative societies, they use Cooperative Societies Act 1912 as their guide, right? This act helps members know how to manage a society together and make decisions that benefit everyone. And companies have a detailed rule book called the Companies Act 2030. This act is like an encyclopedia that covers everything from starting of a company to running it day to day, to raise money from people like issuing shares, and even want to do if the company has to close down. If you want to, if a company wants to wind up, they have to also follow this Companies Act. There are special rule books for banks also. That is Banking Regulation Act 1949. And for insurance companies is Insurance Act 1938. For electricity companies, Central Electricity Act 2003. Okay, we all have gone through it, of course. And we will be learning it also. In these rule books, these rule books make sure that these businesses work in a way that's safe for everyone involved and follow strict guidelines, because they deal with important services like money, safety and energy. These statutes not only tell businesses how to set up and run their operations, but also give instructions on how to use money wisely, how to finance their activities and how to keep track of all their transactions in books of accounts. For example, the Companies Act 2013, along with the Companies Rules 2014, gives companies directions on how to maintain their accounting records properly. It's like telling them how to keep score in the game so everyone can see how well they are doing. It also talks about specific things like how to handle money collected from selling shares or what investments can be made. Okay, there's even a set of rules called the Companies Corporate Social Responsibility Rules 2014, which guides companies on how to spend money on good causes, right? CSR, I hope every one of you remember, they have to spend 2%. Corporate Social Responsibility, this guides the companies on how to spend money on good causes and what happens if they spend more or less than required. So, just like in games where you need to follow rules to play fairly and correctly, in business, a legal framework ensures that companies operate in an orderly manner and everyone knows what's expected of them. So, this is what we call as a legal framework. Hope you understood what it is. Institutional framework. So, think of the institutional framework as a rules and guidelines for a big sports league. Just like FIFA or NBA. Just like these organizations set the rules for how the game is played, there are institutions that set the rules for how businesses should report their financial activities. In India, the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India is like the referee or the rule maker for accounting. They have been given the authority by the government only, right, to make sure that all businesses play by the same financial reporting rules. This helps everyone understand how well each business is playing the game. I mean operating. Okay. The Indian Accounting Standard Board of ICAI is like a committee that writes down these rules. They are the ones that are making the rules. They create high quality accounting standards that cover different areas of accounting, just like rule book covers different parts of a sport. Right now, there are two main rule books. We can say sets of accounting standards, two sets of accounting standards in India. One is accounting standards as per companies rules 2021. And another one is Indian AASs under companies rules 2050. That is Indian accounting standards. These rules books tell businesses how to keep score, or you can say how to keep this financial record so that everyone can compare and understand their performance easily. Additionally, there's another team called the Cost Accounting Standards Board of Institute of Cost Accountants of India. Okay, that's our institute. Okay, they are like specialists who focus on one part of the game, which is cost accounting. So we are focusing on cost accounting only, right? They'll make 24 specific rules, cost accounting standards. Even cost accounting has its own accounting standards, 24 specific rules to help businesses track and report their cost properly. Okay. So just like sport need rules to make sure every team is fair and consistent, the institutional framework in accounting ensures that all businesses report their financial information in a way that's fair, comparable and easy to understand for everyone. Okay. So this is all about institutional framework. Hope you understood. And our final framework, it is regulatory framework. Let's compare the regulatory framework to traffic rules that govern how vehicles move on the road. Just as traffic rules are enforced by traffic police to ensure safety and order on the roads, regulatory frameworks are set of rules enforced by specific authorities to ensure that organizations operate fairly and transparently. Hope every one of you are following our traffic rules, okay? It is very important. Life is very important, so make sure that you are following them. So coming back to our topic, in India, different financial sectors have their own traffic cops. Okay, like as I've told you, I'm going to explain everything with this kind of example. Okay, so don't write about this traffic policeman and all in your exam paper. Once again I'm reminding you. Okay, so there are different financial sectors, right? Different financial sectors have got their own traffic policemen. Let's see. For Reserve Bank of India, very first one. Oversees the money market like a traffic cop for banks, making sure they handle our money safely, right? So the Reserve Bank of India is just like a policeman. We can say traffic policeman for bank. Okay, they make sure, they oversees the money market, make sure they handle our money safely. Next one is Securities and Exchange Board of India. They look after the capital market where companies and investors meet, ensuring that everything is fair and above board. Another one is Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India. They take care of what? Insurance sector, right? Making sure insurance companies keep their promises. Next one is Pension Fund Regulatory and Development Authority. They ensure that pension funds are managed properly so that people have a secure retirement. So there are also other traffic cops, other policemen for specific areas like telecom and business competition, that is like Competition Commission. These authorities make rules that can affect how businesses record and report their financial activities. For example, SEBI's rules influence how listed companies in India must report their finances. Now, IRDA's rules impact how insurance companies do their accounting and reporting. RBI's guidelines, including Basel norms, RBI's guidelines dictate how banks should handle non-performing assets, which are loans that aren't being paid back. We have learned about this non-performing assets in company accounts, and I guess. Now, the Central Electricity Regulatory Commission's regulations determine how electricity companies set their prices and do their accounting. So these four frameworks, legal, conceptual, institutional and regulatory, are like the foundations of a house. They provide a solid base for accounting, especially corporate accounting in India. Okay, so they help make sure that this financial reports businesses generate are high quality, reliable and useful for everyone, contributing to that development of accounting as a whole. So I have explained these four frameworks with four examples. Okay, so you shouldn't write about these examples in your study mat, but you can just add like a reference. Okay, you shouldn't explain very deeply about the example. You should explain, you should focus on the topic. Okay, so I have provided you with very short notes. You can make use of them. Okay, it's not necessary to write everything because, you know, as I said, these notes were prepared by me with the help of a study mat only. Okay, it's just that you want to read the study mat. You can mark them in your study mat in your way. There is no need to write this down. It's just that I made this short one so that they can lead them. They can lead me to explain it. Fine. So this is all about chapter 1.1.